Hello there, and a very warm welcome to the France Buying Guide's YouTube presentation. Well, I'm often asked about how the property process works here, and so this week it's just a few words on the role of the notaire. Some people get a bit confused about the notaire. He's actually a chap who upholds French law throughout any property transaction. He's not working for either the seller or the buyer. He'll also advise on estate planning and inheritance tax. He's employed by the government, and so doesn't owe say out for either party. His task really is to ensure that the whole of the conveyancing goes through properly. You can have two notaires when you're working on when you're buying or selling a house, but normally it is just one, and you can rest assured that that's fine. Having two notaires wouldn't actually mean any more fees; they would simply split it. But if you really want your own one, you can do so. The institution actually dates back hundreds of years, and notaires have always worked for the state, basically as a certifier of legal documents. During a property sale, he ensures all proceedings comply with French law, whether the property is brought direct through a notaire or through an agence immobilière. A notaire still has to oversee the legal aspects, so you always have to have one on board. And he'll also assist all parties to make sure the process goes through smoothly. He does all the searches, and that's all included in his fees as well, by the way, and all the stamp duty, etc. Now, obviously, buying a property anywhere is a serious business, even more so abroad. And many British people like to appoint their own UK legal advisor, which is, in our view, a very good idea. Though it's going to cost you a little bit more, it will give you peace of mind. It's very important in France to get the first act, equivalent to our exchange. It's called the compromis d'avance. You have to have that completely correct, with any clauses therein, such as a condition of a loan or a mortgage or any other sort of condition regarding the property that has to be in there at that point. If it's not, it won't be considered. So it's really important to have that worded exactly. It's not just the translation you need to get in there, it's the actual content. So we can help with that. We have a couple of very good lawyers that you recommend who are specialised in French law as well. The notaire will also advise on whether you can purchase property, for example, through a company, or it's called an SCI here. That sometimes has advantages for future inheritance tax. But again, your own lawyer will be able to help you with that.
Yeah.
The notaire will be present for both signing of the compromis and also the final act, which is called the act of advance. And they're both read out laboriously, all the clauses to both the seller and buyer. And then at the very end of that, the notaire will hand over the keys, and there you are, you've got your property. Bear in mind that the fees are right, it's the only thing between something like 4% and 8% of the property price, but that does, as I say, include all the stamp duty and the searches. And there you are, you get your keys. On the last day, the agent should arrange for a final viewing of the house, because in France it's sold as seen, so you'll find what you see when this, where it was included in the house is there. It'll be sold as seen on later signing. And that's about it, really. If we can help you, recommend to you a property lawyer, do let us know. We're always here to help you. And I will speak to you again very soon. Bye-bye.